Hi guys, today we're going to look at Sodesuri Kami Goshi, not Sodesuri Kami Ashi. We're going to look at Sodesuri Kami Goshi. We've got Zen here to help us, marvelous guy. So the way we're going to look at it is, we're going to look at it in form of our star. I don't know if you can see this. If you can see it, great. Otherwise, just imagine that there are four quarters. There's a plus sign in between us. And we're going to talk about how we're going to move into different quadrants of it. Okay, so the way we start is we're going to ray to each other to begin. And the point to remember is when you're raying, keep your eyes on your opponent, on your uki. If you're the dori, if you're not the dori, if you're the uki, even then keep your eyes on your opponent. So, come up a little. So the way we're going to go over this is, sode itself basically means sleeve, right? So we're going to do sode suri kame goshi. There's multiple ways of gripping the sleeve. So you can have pistol grip this way. You can have a pistol grip this way, or you can even do a basic grip this way. So it's entirely up to you. You want to use these. I am not really a fan of doing the sode from here. It becomes a pistol grip automatically. So it just makes sense. It's easier to grab a double pistol grip this way, or sometimes I like to grab it this way. All of it is allowed. As long as your fingers or your thumb is not going inside the sleeve, it's fine. This works. The referee can see this and it will be fine. If the referee sees that you've got your finger or thumb inside like this, then that's a foul. I'm going to fouls in a different video. For the moment, for Sodesuri Kame Goshi, I'm going to show it first. And then we'll talk about breaking the quadrants a little bit. So let's break this down. So we're going to have a quadrant in front of us. So what we need to do is, just like Ogoshi and Sioi Nagi, what we want to do is we want to get into his half and displace his hip. So, if I'm just coming down here, this doesn't help. Even if I manage to somehow pull him forward, not a lot. He's not really off balance. I haven't achieved kuzushi. So what I need to do is, I need to push against his legs, preferably just above his knee. If I push there, look what happens to his hip. Right? So that's where I want my hip, my backside to go and make contact and push and push, push, push. At the same time, I'm going to be pulling from the top. So, and the stepping that I'm going to do, so from my right quadrant, I'm going to step into his right quadrant with a half step. So I've got my heel slightly off the floor that allows me to turn and bring my feet together. That's the motion that I want with my feet. With the sleeves, making sure that my fingers and my thumbs are not inside his sleeve, I'm going to go up. And this going up motion, right? So there's multiple ways of doing it. One of the more brutal methods of doing it is sending my elbow right into his chin. And that bends him over. That sends his head back first. And his natural reaction when I do this to his head is going to be to come forward. And when that happens, that's when I get my chance to push with my hip at his thighs, sending his hip out of its like space position from here backwards. And when I'm pulling with his sleeves, he comes over. So once again, break it down step by step, grab the sleeves, step. As I step, I'm also sending this over. And this is where my hip comes in. From here, I'm going to let go of this one. I'm going to throw it. So let's say we're doing some randori, we're fighting, I get a grip, I break this, I immediately go for this. I make sure that he doesn't try to grab me. I immediately make sure that I've got a grip, and from here, I'm going to step into his right quadrant. So I need to enter this space here, right? So once again, from here, get this here. I'm inside. I lift, throw. Very small, very basic, not in depth breakdown of Sodesuri Kamigoshi. Have fun, guys. See you guys later.